Widow inheritance refers to a custom by which a male relative of a deceased husband inherits the wife or spouse of the deceased as his own wife. In Karamojong and Pokot culture, once a woman's bride price is paid, she becomes the property of that family she is married to, and even if her husband dies, she is inherited by the brother of the deceased husband. The practice is not only forceful but also denies the woman a right to choose her own spouse. 60-year-old Christine Nachomin, a resident of Amadai village in Kongorok sub-county in Amuda district, narrates that when her husband died in 2008, she was forcefully taken over by her younger brother-in-law.
When my husband passed on, the family came and demanded I married a brother-in-law. I could not resist, lest they would demand for the 60 cows they paid for my bride price. The mother of eight says that she has never found peace in her new marriage. The new husband, who had four other wives, has since abandoned her. After he married me, he left me for his other wives. I now don't know where he is, and I'm all alone. The 60-year-old says all her daughters were married off, and she now lives with her grandchildren. I am all alone. Everyone left me except for the younger grandchildren that I have with. Andrew Ruto, the parish chief of Lokoma Parish in Amudat, reveals that many of the inherited widows are vulnerable to economic and social exploitation.
Be inherited, she will never be taken care of as normal, as a usual husband. This is the person who will be neglected because in the first point, she will be inherited by a man having another five ladies and she will be number six. And all the resources of the brother, the deceased, all the resources will be taken by the inheritor. And the inheritor will own the resources without any question of this lady.
The practice also exposes the widows to new infections. And according to local leaders, many inherited women end up acquiring HIV from their new husbands.
The traditional taboo law that you will be inherited by the brother of the deceased. Even if this man is suffering, you have been knowing that this man is suffering with a disease, maybe TB and other HIV disease, you have to bow with it. That is the worst part of it. You will never have an excuse that this man is suffering. And if you want to exit from this family, then you must pay back the 60 cows back.
This woman inheritance, maybe you have like five women and you inherit two of them. It is very hard for you, for the other husband, to go for ANC hospital, whereby the nurses can check you whether you are positive or not, and they give you other prevention measures so that they protect the child from in the womb. But it's rare for our people to go that.
Dr. Patrick Sagaki, the medical superintendent of Amudat Hospital and also the district health officer, confirms that due to the negative cultural norms, the HIV prevalence in the district has increased.
According to the current survey, by the way, HIV prevalence in this place was at 0.4%. But the new infections are on the rise. Yes, that is what makes us worried. There is a rise in new infections. Like in 2021, we had 175 HIV positives on treatment or in ART. Right now, we are talking about 600 people on treatment in HIV.
Action Aid Uganda has this week conducted intergenerational dialogues covering communities of Loro, Kongorok, Abilayep, Losidok, and locales, with objectives of enhancing intergenerational relationships between men, boys, women and girls that are supportive of adolescent gender and sexual reproductive health, and provide a platform for women and girls to voice and challenge child marriages as a violation of their rights. Part of the UNFPA-funded projects aimed at ending negative social norms that fuel social injustices such as gender-based violence.
We came in, there was a lot of practice of these social norms. And also the communities that we intervened in never had any information on the same. But with our approaches that are through sensitizations, that is through GBV prevention, and also the response bit of it, we've been able to sensitize the communities on the different negative social norms that they practice as culture here.
Report by Rachel Nachwala in Amuda District for the news.